gather together this day around God's Word, and we focus ourselves on what our Lord was willing to do for us. We focus ourselves on the cross and the words that our Savior spoke, the seven words of the cross. We'll begin our service this evening by reading a section from Isaiah that talks about the suffering servant who is our Savior, Jesus. We read, "See, my servant will act wisely. He will be raised and lifted up and highly exalted. Just as there were many who were appalled at him, his appearance was so disfigured beyond that of any man, and his form marred beyond human likeness. So will he sprinkle many nations, and kings will shut their mouths because of him. For what they were not told, they will see, and what they have not heard, they will understand. Who has believed our message? And to whom has the arm of the Lord been revealed? He grew up before him like a tender shoot, and like a root out of dry ground. He had no beauty or majesty to attract us to him, nothing in his appearance that we should desire him. He was despised and rejected by men, a man of sorrow and familiar with suffering. Like one from whom men hide their faces, he was despised, and we esteemed him not. Surely he took up our infirmities and carried our sorrows, yet we considered him stricken by God, smitten by him, and afflicted. But he was pierced for our transgressions. He was crushed for our iniquities. The punishment that brought us peace was upon him, and by his wounds we are healed. We all, like sheep, have gone astray. Each of us has turned to his own way, and the Lord has laid on him the iniquity of us all. He was oppressed and afflicted, yet he did not open his mouth. He was led like a lamb to the slaughter, and as a sheep before her shearers is silent, so he did not open his mouth. By oppression and judgment he was taken away. And who can speak of his descendants? For he was cut off from the land of the living. For the transgressions of my people he was stricken. He was assigned a grave with the wicked and with the rich in his death, though he had done no violence, nor was any deceit in his mouth. Yet it was the Lord's will to crush him and to cause him to suffer. And though the Lord makes his life a guilt offering, he will see his offspring and prolong his days, and the will of our Lord will prosper in his hands. After the suffering of his soul, he will see the light of light and be satisfied. By his knowledge, my righteous servant will justify many, and he will bear their iniquities. Therefore, I will give him a portion among the great, and he will divide the spoils with the strong, because he poured out his life unto death and was numbered with the transgressors. For he bore the sin of many and made intercession for the transgressors." We now join together in prayer. Let us pray. God most holy, look with mercy on this, your family, for whom our Lord Jesus was willing to be betrayed, to be given over into the hands of the wicked, and to suffer death upon the cross. Keep us always faithful to him, our only Savior, who now lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Amen. Amen.
We'll now sing the first three stanzas of "A Lamb Goes Uncomplaining Forth."
Thank you. faint to slaughterland without complaint. That spotless life to offer, bear shame and stripes and wounds and death, anguish and mockery and sins. Willing all this I
from our Lord is the words that he speaks. It's really the main motive for why he came, which is to offer us forgiveness. We read from Luke chapter 23. As they led him away, they seized Simon of Cyrene, who was on his way in from the country, and put the cross on him and made him carry it behind Jesus. A large number of people followed him, including women who mourned and wailed for him. Jesus turned and said to them, "Daughters of Jerusalem, do not weep for me. Weep for yourselves and for your children. For the time will come when you will say, 'Blessed are the barren women, the wombs that never bore, and the breasts that have never nursed.' Then they will say to the mountains, 'Fall on us,' and to the hills, 'Cover us.' For if men do these things when the tree is green, what will happen when it is dry? Two other men, both criminals, were also led out with him to be executed. When they came to the place called the Skull, they crucified him, along with the criminals, one on his right and the other on his left. And Jesus said, 'Father, forgive them, for they do not know what they are doing.' And they divided up his clothes by casting lots." We'll now continue with singing our next hymn, "Behold the Lamb of God," hymn 101. Thank you. The next word that we hear Jesus speak to us from the cross are words that he can speak because of what he does. He gives us comfort. As he speaks to this criminal, he promises him paradise. And he could do that because he's making the payment for our spot in paradise as he speaks them. We read, "There was a written notice above him which read, 'This is the King of the Jews.' One of the criminals who hung there hurled insults at him, 'Aren't you the Christ? Save yourself and us.' But the other criminal rebuked him. 'Don't you fear God?' he said. 'Since you are under the same sentence, we are punished justly, for we are getting what our deeds deserve, but this man has done nothing wrong.' Then he said, 'Jesus, remember me when you come into your kingdom.' And Jesus answered him, 'I tell you the truth. Today you will be with me in paradise.'" We'll now continue by singing our next hymn, hymn 105, "O Sacred Head Now Wounded." We'll sing stanzas 1, 4, 6, and 7. The next word that we turn our attention to from the cross is Jesus, as he looks to keep the fourth commandment, is Jesus making sure that he is taking care of everything, even his mother. We hear Jesus not only taking care of his mother, and we watch and we see as this all unfolds, Jesus is also taking care of us. We read, near the cross of Jesus stood his mother's sister, Mary, the wife of Cleopas, and Mary Magdalene. When Jesus saw his mother there, and the disciple whom he loved standing nearby, he said to his mother, "Dear woman, here is your son." And to the disciple, "Here is your mother." From that time, this disciple took her into his home. We now continue with singing hymn 119, "Were You There?" We turn our attention to the fourth word that our Savior spoke from the cross that's recorded in Scripture. We hear the agony of the cross as he's suffering the weight of our sin. We hear as Jesus says, "My God, why have you forsaken me?" He is suffering the hell that we deserved. We read, "From the sixth hour until the ninth hour, darkness came over all the land. About the ninth hour, Jesus cried out in a loud voice, 'Eloi, Eloi, lama sabachthani,' which means, 'My God, why have you forsaken me?' When some of those standing there heard this, they said, 'He's calling Elijah.' Immediately, one of them ran and got a sponge and filled it with wine vinegar, put it on a stick and offered it to Jesus to drink. The rest said, "Now leave him alone. Let's see if Elijah comes to save him." We now continue by singing our next hymn response, hymn 117, "O Dearest Jesus." We'll sing stanzas 1, 3, 4, 6, and 7. Turn our attention to the fifth word that our Savior spoke. We see that he left nothing undone. Everything that Scripture prophesied, everything that Scripture foretold, Jesus did. And he does that when he speaks these words, "I am thirsty," we read. Later, knowing that all was now completed, and so that the Scripture would be fulfilled, Jesus said, "I am thirsty." A jar of wine vinegar was there, so they soaked a sponge in it, put the sponge on a stalk of a hyssop plant, and lifted it to Jesus' lips. We now continue by singing hymn 127, Stricken, Smitten, and Afflicted. To the sixth word from the cross, we hear Jesus say that wonderful word, that the payment for sin has been made. It is finished. We read, a jar of wine vinegar was there, so they soaked a sponge in it, put the sponge on a stalk of a hyssop plant, and lifted it to Jesus' lips. When he had received the drink, Jesus said, "It is finished." We continue with the hymn response, Alas, and Did My Savior Bleed? We'll sing the first four stanzas.
What he devoted
for sinners such as I. Was it for crimes that I had done?
That we hear our Savior speak from the cross, we see the full extent of which he was willing to go for our sin. Death. He gave up his spirit into death, we read. It was now about the sixth hour, and darkness came over the whole land until the ninth hour, for the sun stopped shining, and the curtain of the temple was torn in two. Jesus called out with a loud voice, "Father, into your hands I commit my spirit." When he had said this, he breathed his last. We now respond with hymn 140, "God Was There on Calvary. We'll sing stanzas 1 and 4 through 6. Time during the service where we'd set aside a portion of our income to offer up in service to the Lord. Again, as always, St. Jacoby or Zion, you can set aside your offering and wait till we meet again to offer it up. You can drop by the church office here at Zion and drop it in the basket, or you can mail it. Either one of those, doesn't matter, St. Jacoby, Zion, or whatever. You can drop it off at the office, mail it into the church, or just set it aside until we meet again and then offer it up then. We'll continue now with the bidding prayer. We'll pray it as it's printed for us in our service folder. Let us pray for the whole church, that our gracious Father would defend her from the devil and keep her faithful to her Lord. Almighty and everlasting God, you have revealed your saving name to the world through Jesus Christ our Lord. Protect us from the assaults of the evil one, and help us remain faithful to your word, so that in every adversity we may stand firm in our faith and give ourselves fully to our Savior's work, through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen. Amen.
Let us pray for those who serve in public ministry and for all the people of God. Almighty and everlasting God, you rule over all things for the good of your people. Preserve us from the divisive spirits and false teachers. Give your servants the grace to proclaim Christ joyfully in word and deed, so that all who hear them may come to know their Savior better and to be strengthened for their lives of service through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Let us pray for those who are being instructed in the word, that they may remain firm in the simple faith of baptism. Almighty and everlasting God, you make us your own dear children by the washing of rebirth and renewal in the Holy Spirit. Give strength to all who are buried with Christ in baptism, that each day they may die to sin and rise again to live new and holy lives through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Let us pray for our earthly government, our rulers, and all who are in authority. Almighty and everlasting God, you have established earthly government to keep a measure of order in this dying world, to protect us from the disorder of sin. Give to all rulers the wisdom to govern well and to all citizens the desire to obey them, so that we may live peaceful lives in all godliness and holiness through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Let us pray that our gracious Father would protect us and our communities from the many earthly calamities that threaten us. Almighty and everlasting God, on all sides we are surrounded by danger from wars and famine, from disease and pestilence, with the devil begrudging us every minute of our lives. Protect us from all these miseries, so that your name may still be glorified in them, and so that we may safely pass through them to your heavenly kingdom, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Let us pray for those who are outside the church, that they may come to know the one true God and Jesus Christ, whom he has sent. Almighty and everlasting God, your Son was lifted up on the cross so that he might draw all people to himself. though the proclamation of your word, or through the proclamation of your word, mercifully gather from the nations a people that are your very own, that we may join together around your throne in glory to praise and to thank you forever through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Let us pray for our enemies and for all those who hate us. Almighty and everlasting God, no one can harm us without grieving you, whose name we bear. We ask that you would change the hearts of those who work against us and who hate us without reason. Give them repentance and faith so that they may be glad with us and find joy in your love. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Let us pray for all who suffer under cross and trial. Almighty and everlasting God, you sent your Son into the world to bear our griefs and to carry our sorrows. Help those who are suffering for your name's sake and who are struggling against temptation, that they may not be overwhelmed with sadness, but find relief in your grace through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Finally, let us pray for all those things for which our Lord would have us ask in the words he himself has taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever.
Amen.
Amen.